We'll now take leaders' questions under Standing Order 29. Deputy Micheál Martin, please.
Taoiseach, yesterday in response to the barbaric murder of Gard Hutch, being the latest in a series of very callous murders across the capital city, you did say initially in your response that you could do nothing to stop the killings. And also one senior guard said there's no immediate end in sight of this. And an interpretation of what you were saying, Taoiseach, essentially was that the state is almost powerless to stop this, to actually turn the tide against the criminal gangs and the overlords, the drug overlords, who are controlling parts of our city and indeed country. And what I want to put to you, Taoiseach, is that I think there's a need for the state to really get into the face of these criminals and assert who is in charge of our country and make sure that crime does not pay. The 2009 legislation is there, and the full implementation of that is required, which created new offences in terms of directing organised crime, new offences in terms of participation in organised crime, invoking the official the Offences Against the State Act and the utilisation of the Special Criminal Court, and obviously depending a lot on intelligence that the Gardaí would have built up over time. The Gardaí and this, the full armoury of the state needs to meet these criminals head on and be constantly in their face in terms of ensuring that they do not reign with the ease, the apparent ease that they do at the moment when in broad daylight they can run up and murder people in cold blood. So the full implementation, Taoiseach, of the 2009 Act is called for. Secondly, in terms of the Mini Criminal Assets Bureau, and I know in a recent reply Minister Fitzgerald was careful to avoid any commitment to the establishment of that and drew a distinction between the criminal asset or the criminal profiling or the profiling of people in Store, the new unit in Store Street, from the establishment of locally based criminal asset bureaus that would again get in the face of criminals on the ground who have unexplained wealth in various localities and who are running the scenes there. And that's something, Taoiseach, that's in the programme for government now, but there's no real sense of any commitment to it. And the community groups that we met last week were clear that they got no sense of any commitment to establish many criminal asset bureaus. The term many is used, basically locally based asset bureaus that would be on the ground targeting these individuals, targeting their wealth and making life extremely uncomfortable for them.
Have you
and
question,
thirdly,
Deputy?
If I may,
no,
Taoiseach,
I'll have you a question.
Yes, and I put Thank it to you. Him. There's two already put in terms of the 2009 Act on the Criminal Assets Bureau. Because the sense is that the National Criminal Assets Bureau is removed from the streets now.
All right.
Its influence isn't
Thank
there.
You, Deputy.
The third question, if I may,
is
the Misuse of Drugs Act, which I put to you yesterday, which has been going on for quite some time. The drug now, the main issue on the streets in North Inner City is tablets and the Z drugs, as they're called. The change of regulations is required, the signing of regulations is required to criminalise that activity and to give the Gardaí the powers that they require to arrest people who are distributing tablets across the city. Those powers are not there, and incredibly, the Gardaí are not in a position to move effectively on that particular phenomenon, which is a huge source of revenue to the drug lords and which is damaging young people in those communities.
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
First of all, Senator Deputy Martin, what I said yesterday was that this was a murderous feud between two rival families. We've had experience of this in the past, and pleadings to the McCarthy Dundons didn't do anything, and pleadings to the General didn't do anything, and pleadings to the Gilligan gang didn't do anything, until intelligence, personnel, investment in resources and capacity was able to take these people off the streets and put them behind bars. And the same applies here now. At least in those cases in different years, and those criminal gangs were based here in Ireland, there's now a very strong international connection here where hits are ordered from abroad, and where this is as much about sending signals internationally about the so-called status of criminal gangs as it is about power and money and misery here. And those who are sent to carry out killings or to attempt killings for in some cases very slow, very small sums are really a signal from those who live with the trappings of wealth and the shallowness of wealth abroad and do their dirty business from abroad. Let me say to you very clearly, Deputy Martin, and to everybody else in the House here, that the government will not back in the face of this. We've had experience in different counties over different years, and it takes a long time to actually deal with these things. Now, the position is that obviously in respect of local resources here, Minister met with all of the communities, as you did yourself, quite recently. I intend to meet with them myself when it's appropriate, with the leadership of the communities and all the public representatives. But as of the 31st of March, there are 598 Gardaí assigned to the Dublin Metropolitan Region North Central, of which 251 are assigned to Stour Street and 186 assigned to Mount Joy, and 33 newly attested Gardaí have been assigned to the Dublin Metropolitan North Region area also. Now, Operation Hybrid, as you know, has been put in place to manage the recent increase in this violence and murderous activities by these gangs. Over 1,000 lines of inquiry are being pursued, and a significant number of statements and exhibits have been gathered, and widespread searches have been carried out. Arms are being seized, people are being brought before the courts, and cases prepared. The courts will do their duty. As I said yesterday, over 1,000 extensive armed checkpoints have taken place since February. That's over 80 a week. And more than 500 patrols and 400 searches have been conducted under this operation across the Dublin region. And those checkpoints and patrols are significantly supported at Cancora by armed support groups like the Emergency Response Unit and the Regional Support Unit patrols. There's a significant amount of CCTV and mobile phone traffic has been examined, and every investigation is overseen by a dedicated senior investigating officer. Arrests have been made, and arrests were made on the 24th of May in connection with the shootings of Eddie Hutch, a senior, and Gareth Hutch, respectively. This is reviewed on a weekly basis. I've asked the Minister for Justice and the Garda Commissioner with the Assistant Commissioner to come this evening for a full security briefing at 7 p.m. particularly in respect of the extra facilities and resources being made available in the North Inner City to deal with this issue, and I'll inform the House of the ongoing activity here. Believe me, Deputy Martin, the State and the Government are not going to lie down in front of this intimidation.
Thank you very much, Taoiseach. We have 1 minute for supplementaries, Deputy Martin.
Thank you, Taoiseach, for your response, but I would point out that notwithstanding that huge effort, and the Gardaí are, and I accept the bona fides of the Gardaí in everything they're trying to do, but notwithstanding everything you've said, there's been 7 murders within 100 days in our capital city. I mean, that says it all about the state we're in right now and the degree of power that these people are currently wielding on our streets. You didn't answer the questions that I put to you, Taoiseach. I would say under the 2009 Act, there was a stronger capacity to really make life uncomfortable for many of these criminals, who are well known to the Gardaí from their intelligence and so on. Secondly, can you let us know, are you really committed to the excerpt in the programme for government dealing with the establishment of a locally based criminal asset bureau units to really get stuck in to people on the ground, lower and middle level drug pushers and so on, who have unexplained wealth, obviously from the proceeds of crime, and who are ruling the roost in their local communities, who are giving up to 200 to 300 euros to 13-year-olds and 14-year-olds to distribute tablets around the streets. That's what's going on,
Deputy, please.
That is what's going on in the streets of North Inner City. Young kids can earn a fortune. Just bring that packet over there or whatever, we'll give you 200. They're telling the other kids, you're a mug not to be involved in this. This is quite lucrative and so on like that. So we really have to listen to the people on the ground, and I think that's extremely important. The third issue, Taoiseach, and I didn't get a reply today or yesterday, and Deputy Shorthall raised this. The Gardaí need powers in terms of arresting people who are selling prescription drugs on our streets. The Minister for Health needs to amend or sign into law new regulations under the Misuse of Drugs Act. That's why I called for a multi-agency approach yesterday.
All right,
it's
thank
not
you,
just
Deputy.
All security. When can we expect
Deputy, you need to conclude.
That legislation to come on stream, Taoiseach, to give the additional powers that the Gardaí need. And we're being told by community activists that the Gardaí are saying this to them, that they don't have the power to tackle this particular issue.
Thank you
and
very
finally,
much.
Finally, Taoiseach, would you agree that there's a need for a multi-agency task force to be put into place involving the local public representatives in the area and indeed community activists as well to take a multi-faceted approach to this, but above all to make life extremely uncomfortable for those who are ruling the roost at the moment?
Taoiseach.
Yes, this, the last point you've raised has been discussed with the Minister for Justice, with all of the groups and the communities. I think this is something that's really important. I have to say that there are some of the groups have been in existence in different parts of the country for very many years now, and it may well be that they may need to be reinvigorated in terms of what it is, the work that they do and so on like that. That's an issue that's under discussion. Be clear on this. These gangland crimes, these killings, these ordering of attempts to kill are not being done on a whim down in the corner of some kitchen in inner city Dublin. These are being directed from international sources. So there needs to be a far greater connection and a far more vigilant operation with international police forces and intelligence in respect of gangs like this. And I make the point again that what's happening internationally is as much a signal being sent to other international criminals about the status of a gangland crime from Ireland, the Kinahan gang or whatever, about what they can do. And these gangs are intent on retaliatory killings here in Dublin. And my concern is obviously for the people living in the areas, for the communities, for the children in particular. A school had to be locked down yesterday. Now, you make a number of other points. The Misuse of Drugs Act is the one that deals with the licensed tablets. In order to deal with an extension of this, you need primary legislation, and that's being prepared by the Minister for Health. You can't introduce the regulations until you have the primary legislation, and I hope that when it comes,
need to conclude.
There was a case, and I hope that when it comes, that we can agree as a House to deal with this. In respect of the mini CABs, the Garda Commissioner has appointed local investigators in different parts of the country to deal with this very issue, and they act as mini cabs in different locations around the country. Now, as I say, I'm meeting with the Commissioner this evening at 7 o'clock to have a full security update in respect of what it is extra that's being provided here. Are there other resources that the Garda Commissioner and the police force need to deal with this?
All right, thank you, Taoiseach.
And obviously, I intend to go and meet with all the public representatives and the community leaders when it's appropriate to do so in respect of dealing with this. And I expect that we'll get the support from all members of the House, because it's an issue that affects everybody.
Thank you very much.